Hello there once again, YouTubers. Today we have something else that's different, that's for sure. Now, I'm sure everybody's heard of background music, but how many have heard of foreground music? Well, that's what this player is. If we look right in the front, it's AEI foreground music. This is a Paragon 6-B. Now, this would have been used in stores or in pizza joints and things like that to play music. You know, I call it background music, but they call it foreground music. And the format was, of all things again, the Munch tape system, like this. And I don't know if you can read any of this, but these are pretty popular tunes from the, in fact, what I've got here. I do have six cartridges starting in 1982, clear on up through 1985. So this was the popular music back then. And unlike the Munch system that usually played stereo, you know, you had four tracks, two of them were for stereo on one side, two of them stereo on the lower side. This has four tracks, but they're monophonic. There's one, two, three, four tracks, and obviously strictly mono. And they could put a lot of music on the tape as a result. I mean, you could listen to the tape almost all day without hearing the same song twice. And note that I have a couple different size tapes. So I have the smaller one here, and I also have the larger one by comparison. And I'm going to assume that these probably came from a pizza joint, because I see on this thing here, Goodfellas Pizza, and I'm going to guess that that's where it was played, you know, is music for the patrons. If we look inside, there is, of course, our playback tape pad there, and this is a sensor on the other side. So what would happen is, after it was through playing one track, it would electronically sense and play the next track in line. It would continue on down and then go right back to number one. I'm going to remove this from the top for just 1 second to show you that this was done electronically. And for those that wanted to, they could press this little button right there and advance to the next track if they wanted to. This had two outputs, one on the board up top here and one on the back side. We're currently plugged on the back side and feeding it through this little amplifier right here. Now, I'm tempted to play some music here, and I probably will here, but I want you to understand that this music is probably licensed. Give me 1 second here. Let me just put this down and put the top back on here. I got background music here too. I got the stupid clock going in the background here. All right, so that's put back on. And what we're going to do is, I'm going to just release this here. I'm going to throw the tape in, and we're going to play very briefly one song here. Advance it for you here, so you'll see how that's done. Yeah, I don't want to play too much, because they're probably going to recognize this, and then I'm going to get zinged for the damn thing. So for that reason, I'm going to stop playing the music here. But you get the general idea. An awful lot of music, as I said, on these tapes here. And just to give you an idea what kind of music is on here, again, this is from, I don't know if you can read it there, the stupid thing doesn't focus too well, but it's from August of 82. And these were licensed, I'm sure. But for instance, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Eric Clapton and his band, Tom Petty and the Heartbeat Breakers, Pablo Cruz, The Beatles, The Police, The Moody Blues, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, Supertramp, the Alan Parsons Project, the Who, Atlanta Rhythm Section, Bob Seger, Crosby, Stills and Nash again, Little River Band, Juice Newton, Paul Davis, Rita Coolidge, and the list goes on and on. Supertramp, Grassroots, and so forth. This is all popular music that was being played through, so I'm sure this was licensed. In any event, it's kind of a unique unit. It's not for me, though. I'm going to be selling this. I bought it because I thought it was unique, and I wanted to play with it, and we got it up and running okay. This has to be fed through an amplifier, obviously. It's just a basic playback unit with an on-off switch on the front. Your play and release on the side here, just like the typical Muntz are. And like I said, you have your playback area here and a sensing area over here. And again, you can change your tracks back here. And this is another output as well as the one on the back. So there you have it. We know this is from the late 70s through probably the late 80s as background music. Of course, times have changed. Shortly afterwards, you had the Muzak systems, you know, over the air, and then digital stuff. So it's a whole new world out there. This is old technology, but I'm sure it's going to appeal to somebody. The entire setup, not including this little puppy right here because that's mine, but the unit and the six tapes, I'm going to sell at $175 plus shipping. So if you have an interest, by all means, just contact me through the YouTube messaging system or contact me directly through my email. One quick look up at the top here for you. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed seeing something a little bit different. A foreground music system, not a background music system. Have a great day.